Hello, Internet. Big Dave here, and I am cheap. Hello, Internet. It's Big Dave here, and welcome back to more Vertical Drop Heroes HD. So, a little bit of an interesting thing has happened, or not interesting, I suppose you could say tragic even. I've had a lost episode. I had a 20-minute run in which I played the same character for the whole time. His name was Al Muncher. He was glorious. And somehow the audio did not get recorded for that. Or I should say the audio got recorded. It didn't get saved. Because I do generally record these in two or three game chunks. So I do like two or three videos at a time. And somehow the audio for that epic run did not indeed get recorded. So I am super sad about that. But let's soldier on, shall we? We've got Storm Strider, Robin Muncher, and Smoke Render, or Smoker Ender. So let's see here. Health-wise, we have an obvious front runner here. He also has decent damage, our highest top-end damage. He's got arrows and Midas Touch, which is a new ability that we may have gotten in that last episode. I'm not sure. May have been in the actual last real recorded and released episode. We've got Greedy, we've got Necromancer, 25% chance of killed enemies becoming skeletons. I think that is definitely something that we're going to try out. We love Greedy. We absolutely love Greedy. So yeah, Storm Strider it is. So here we go, Storm Strider into the fray. Into the fray we go. Yeah, we are lacking cash to do anything but upgrade our peace orbs, so we're not going to do that. We are going to go forward, and we are off into the Goblin Forest. Now, things begin. We do have the buckler makes us a bit slow. It is slow, but it also means that we're a bit more methodical, if you will, that we kind of have a bit more of an incentive to be careful with our movements, and perhaps we even will be careful with our movements. The strategy that we're currently using is to pretty much kill everything, trigger all alarms and kill everything. The strategy we should also be using is actually getting crates. So let's get those crates. So we're going to trigger alarms, we're going to kill everything. You know, we collected a few peace orbs, but now we are in a position where it is time to just straight murder. And that is what we are now in the process of doing. Oh, there's one of our necromancer trait skeletons. I like it. I like it a lot. Managed to clear those spikes. I was kind of doubtful there for a second. We don't have iron foot, so spikes will do a little bit of damage to us. So, let's see. We have a trio down here of nasties. Let's see if we can drop down and kind of just give him an arrow in the face. There we go. All right, buddy, what do you want? A powerful dark sniper is somewhere nearby. There's a bounty of 50 coins if you defeat him. I think I can. So let's go for it. Want to hop over here and grab this key. You know, this first couple of levels, or this first level especially, and the first couple of levels in general, are really, really big. They are building our run. So that's why I'm going out of my way to go back and get crates and for coins and go back and get keys. Because it's huge. It's huge. The keys and things that we do get now will definitely... You have 6 keys on the first level. That's crazy. But those keys will allow us to play a much, much more solid game as we continue through. So we've got a key to possibly free a thief over here. You guys know I like thieves if you've been watching the series, or thieves, as I think the English language would dictate that you do pronounce it. So we're going to go over here. We're going to check on what this is. This is sparks, lightning bolts, yada, yada. So the thief is great because he is going to drop a bunch of coins. I never did see that dark sniper. Wonder where he is. Anyways, so the thief is going to start dropping coins. And because we have greedy, those coins are just going to automatically come into us. And that is lovely. Now, I wish the thief had sort of stayed stuck as he was, but he did not. So I'm going to do everything I can to keep the thief alive. Nice little jump over my arrow there, boss man. So again, trying to keep the thief alive, because if the thief lives long enough, he will indeed drop that, the red gem of wealth and power and justice and truth, and we will collect it. So the blue vials is something I've not really even necessarily consciously noticed. The blue vials will refill one of your active abilities. So I got that blue vial and I went from 3 arrows to 4 arrows. So I never really, I guess, mentioned the blue vials, never paid them much attention, but that's what the blue vials do in case you have been wondering. So I can't get up to that restoration shrine over there. So I think we are pretty much done. I guess we could free this thief. There's another alarm we can set off. So let's free this guy. He's going to start dropping mad coins for us here. You guys still say that, you kids? You still say mad? I don't know. I doubt you do. And we're going to go ahead and clean up here. Last couple of enemies. We're going to continue this train of magical coins being sucked into our body. This level is lousy with necromancer skeletons now. It's too bad that we are... Man, military operations going on over my house. It probably won't pick up on the mic, but there is a really loud chopper flying over my house right now, really low, and it sounds like not a news copter, it sounds like a real deal Black Hawk or something. Wow, things are shaking outside. Is it the zombie apocalypse? Did it happen while I was recording this video? Let me know in the comments below. All right, guys, so we got the gray statue. Nothing really here, just warning us, you know, electricity and lightning don't mix, so don't mix them. Gonna maintain that pacifist run, you know. Again, yeah, we are here kind of taking our time on this first level, but that's what we do. You know, we took our time on the first level, taking our time now on the second level, because yeah, we want to get we don't like that at all. We want to get as much as we can in the way of, there we go. So that's gonna get us something better than nothing. Got a couple of gold pieces off that. So yeah, we're going off the rails a little bit. We're missing good opportunities. We're missing keys. We're missing enemies we could kill for experience and gold. I never did see that dark sniper. I don't know. Did I miss him? I don't know. No dark sniper in the last level. I'm not going to get out of this without... Oh, good, I blocked it. I was going to say I'm not going to get out of this without getting hit, but then my sweet, sweet buckler blocked most of the damage from that arrow. So another alarm that we can set off for fun. And profit? Not really profit. And can we hit that guy all the way over there? Let's see. There we go. I'm the dark sniper. That's why I didn't see a dark sniper. Oh my goodness. No way we're getting over these spikes without taking some damage. And at least it was only one. So we can kind of rejoice in that. All right, we're going to drop down here. And we're just going to try to do a little bit of commando duty here. All right, we got some skeletons. Too bad they're stuck over here. Another good block and a miss, so that was very nice. These skeletons, I wish they looked a little bit more distinct. They have blue swirlies on their serial killer swirly marks on their head, as opposed to red, which is the enemy skeleton. I just wish they were a little more distinct. Two keys to pop a checkpoint. It's just not worth it yet. We collected about 100 gold and five levels of experience in the first level. So right now that's extremely valuable. So we're gonna keep doing that first level. There's gonna be a time when that first level is tedious to the point that we're gonna be willing to pay 100 gold in order to actually get a checkpoint. But that time is not now. Oh, come on now. Wow, that was even worse. Yeah, maybe I should just walk over there. Yeah, I'd probably have more success if I just walked over there. Yeah, there we go. Wasted 3 arrows trying to snipe the guy when I could have just easily walked over and punched him in the face. Man, so I love the necromancer ability, but right now these guys just kind of hang out. They don't really do anything. I wish that they would jump down and move through the level. They do fall sometimes, but sometimes they seem to get stuck and just kind of hang out in one spot. Oh, I didn't need to jump into that. So these guys are going down, which is good. I like that. But it seemed in the last level like a lot of the guys were just sort of hanging out. This parade of... see these guys? They're just kind of stuck here. I wish those... Ooh. Damn you. I wish those guys would fall down. But they're not gonna. Hey, I can get in here without spending a key. That's nice. This would be a really big ripoff if there wasn't an alternate way down here. 3 crates for a key? I mean, I guess that's 12 gold. I guess that's something. 4 enemies to gain 50 XP, sure. I'm not really at that period yet where I fear enemies, so that helps out a lot when I get a proposition like that. Since I don't actually fear the enemies, 2 guys stacked up there on top of one another, it's not a big deal. Ugh. Okay, good. I made it. I said, please don't get hit twice. Just please don't get hit twice. Okay, so, I think we're just going to go to town here. We're going to try Midas Touch because, yeah, I don't know. I haven't, look at all that gold. I haven't tried it yet, so that was a good time to try Midas Touch. Let's get down here and give it another go, another Midas Touch there. Not really sure what that's doing. I mean, obviously the golden bricks fall and do a lot of damage. That's nice. But apart from that, I'm not really sure. So, Skeleton Army, go! I do have some arrows, so I should probably use those. I'm taking a lot of hits, but I'm not really too concerned in terms of the life, the damage that I'm taking. I'm pretty invincible at this stage of the game. I mean, I guess I could go off the rails and just really do a poor job of playing and actually get killed. And I wouldn't put it past myself to do that. But I think right now we're pretty much okay. I noticed in the last couple of episodes that I missed a few obvious things that I could have gotten to better myself in the last screen here. So at times I noticed that I left like a crate over here on the side or something. And I'm just trying to be conscious of this last screen and not leaving too early. And we are on to the Endless Desert. When the timer reaches zero, the bombs will blow and kill your hero. So a bomb level. We always love the bomb levels. Actually, we don't. All right, so we got a pacifist orb over there. Turn invisible for 10 seconds. I like that. I like that in general, but I don't... the spikes. I don't really have a need for it right now. So our pacifist run has ended, which was inevitable and not necessarily all that big of a deal. There are those bombs that we were talking about before. Hoping for skeletons. There we go. And good. These guys are actually going to fall, so I like that. Very nice. Very nice. Using those hopefully effectively, like bombs. That was nice. Dropped it right on that guy's head. And alarms are being triggered. I guess these skeletons can trigger alarms, or did I trigger that alarm? I don't know. Well, regardless, it's okay. We want alarms triggered because we want things that we can kill. I never noticed that witty banter coming from our hero there. Another one bites the dust, says our hero. How droll, how droll. Chest over here, might as well take a chance on it. Why not? Coins. Well, we like coins. Don't need the life, so we're good to go here. Perhaps another Midas Touch might be nice here, because we can maybe... Nah, not quite. I was going to say maybe we can rain down some golden death on these guys, but golden shower, not in our future. Not in our future. More reasons than one, actually. Bomb, we're gonna avoid that. Oh, overshot it. That guy goes to the Big Dave School of Archery. All right, so we have a key here, and we do need a little bit of health, so let's go ahead and grab that. Trigger an alarm, which is gonna bring the wolves out. The gnolls, if you will. I always sort of read those guys as werewolves, but I guess technically they're gnolls because that's what it says their name is when you actually attack them. So yeah, my skeleton army doing pretty good down there until they mindlessly walked onto spikes. More gold, more gold. Don't know that I really want to free this guy. I don't know that there's necessarily any point in freeing this guy. Okay, yeah, so my skeleton army can indeed trigger alarms, which is fine. The more the merrier, as they say. Although who they is, I don't really know. I guess this is the part, if I'm a real YouTuber, where I say, if you know who they is, tell me in the comments below. Yeah. Moving on. Skeleton army pouring down like water. They will slowly erode the resistance of my enemies. Don't go over here. No. Oh, all right. Well, hang out in that corner then. Make sure that nobody comes through there, bud. Another helpful tip. Keys are limited resource. Use them wisely. Thank you, Cryptic Statues. Spawn 4 enemies gain 75 XP. Sure, why not? Maybe some of my skeletons will do a little work. There's one. This guy's stuck over here as well. All right. I guess I could maybe Midas Touch to get them out, but I don't know that I really care enough. What does that say about me? I'm not a very good skeleton army father, am I? Just not. That's a problem with our community. You know, young men just not living up to their skeletal duties. Oh, hey, we freed a wizard somehow. Not really sure how that happened. You know, if you're going to do the deed and you're going to birth a skeleton, you need to make sure that you're there to take care of that skeleton. Guide it. Make sure that it understands how everything works, the ways of the world. I do like that the wizard is actually shielding my minions as well. So that is a big, big plus. Arrows, arrows, arrows. Die, Gnoll King. Or excuse me, Alpha Gnoll. Don't want to disrespect your position. I'm sure you worked very hard to gain the title of Alpha Gnoll, and who am I to minimize your accomplishments? No reason to go back up, as far as I can tell. We will take that restoration shrine, and we will depart. Nothing here that I'm leaving behind. No, it all looks good and clear. Here we go. Strange statue. Every time a minion dies, you will see a swarm of flies. Man, I hate flies. So if you don't know, the flies don't abide by the normal rules of being killed. So you actually can't kill flies with your sword or other weapons. You have to run flies into blocks in order to kill them, or run them into yourself. In general, flies don't do a lot of damage, but if you start to get a cascade of flies, it can get very... Oh, there we go. It was worth it. It can get very, very nasty. Spikes everywhere over here. Oh my goodness. Two enemies for a key? Sure, why not? I am at that part of the game where I do kind of start considering whether or not I should... There's a fly. Whether or not I actually should bother to trigger alarms and kill every enemy. I do want to continue my upward level curve. You know, I want to keep getting more XP so I can get more levels. Lightning strike in random directions. You know what? That sounds like fun. That was fun. I'm just going to tell you straight up. That was fun. All right, so these bastard fly-spawning mummies need to die. Flies everywhere, man. And they explode into like three or four flies when they die. Oh, okay. So many keys in this run. So many. Right onto spikes. Okay, trigger an alarm, sure. So we're going to have to use a little bit of creativity here. Let's do a Midas touch, why not? You know, it's worth it. That'll help us a little bit. Falling onto spikes. Seems par for the course at this point. So the flies are starting to get out of control here. We did definitely need that little bit of life that we just grabbed. And we will evade that fly. We will try to evade that swarm, and we will, but we won't evade that bolt of justice which came for us and killed us. Okay. Not sure what happened there. Oh, crafty. Oh, it's our actual boss down there wreaking some havoc and causing a ruckus. So let's head down, I guess. I really want to take care of these fly spawners because these guys are going to... Or these guys don't fly spawn flies until I kill them. So I really want to turn these guys into fly spawners. I want a clear out. I don't want to have to worry about flies flying in and chipping me away five HP at a time. All right, well, before we start combat, let's go ahead and jump over here. And what did we get there? I didn't see. Oh, we could unlock here just to bypass this boss, but really that's not worth it in the slightest. So let's just go ahead and beat the crap out of him. We have the damage in order to make pretty short work of him. And we have enough life not to worry too much about getting hit by him. We will not evade the flies. I thought we were going to evade the flies. Oop, that is not how that was supposed to go. Can I jump out of the hole? Can I jump out of the hole? All right, come on. All right, and I'm gonna leave that guy over in the corner as well as my skeleton. Again, abandoning my children. Don't be angry. Do not rage. Your skills are changed. Excuse me. Just for this stage. So magic blades and Midas touch. Huh. So I wonder if it randomized Midas touch and it landed on Midas touch again. That would be kind of interesting if it did. Magic blades, I like. I like magic blades quite a bit. Actually, this might be an opportune moment for magic blades with an enemy below us. There we go. So we are going to definitely see some difficulty here with facing off against some of these enemies. Restoration Shrine is going to be welcome, so I'm going to go ahead and spam out pretty much all my magic blades that I can, and then restore. And this is going to be a huge help, as you can see. I mean, it's just laying waste. I think I have magic blades stacked on top of magic blades right now. What have you got? What have you got? Call a hero. Call a hero. Purchase this ability for future heroes. Summon a random hero to your side, either a paladin, barbarian, thief, elf, archer, elven archer. I think it should say. I would prefer if it said that, because I don't like elf. Elf sounds dumb. Elf. Or a wizard. So, that could be a really cool ability. My skeleton. What happened? My freaking skeleton triggered an alarm somewhere. 305 gold. Sure. Why not? I mean, it's not the best ability that I could be unlocking right now, but it's a good ability all the same. Sounds like fun. You know, it's a video game. Let's have a little fun, guys. Just a little bit. You know, just a little bit. So as I said, the last run we had was an epic run with a single character. And this is actually shaped up to be a repeat of that. So another epic run through the game. We are on level 5 now, is it? 5 or 6? And 2 enemies for a key is definitely good. And I'm happy. I'm happy that that actually got replaced by another run that was nearly as good. Hey, we got the Reaver! 150 kills in a single run. So we've unlocked another new weapon. We actually unlocked a weapon on the last playthrough, the last episode, which was Unseen by Your Eyes. New power, Ice Age. Freeze visible enemies for up to 5 seconds and rain giant ice shards on your enemies. Oh my god, giant ice shards sounds wonderful. Running a little bit low on money, but 320 gold, sure. Why not? You know, I like the idea of all the permutations that could be created by these skills that I'm unlocking, and that's part of the fun of this game. Figuring out all these, unlocking all these skills so that you create all these just crazy, over-the-top guys. So what do we have here? A new trait, Bloodlust. No, sir. Regain 1 to 4 HP per melee strike, but lose 1 HP per second. I actually, that's a pretty good proposition, but I tend to, well, sometimes play pacifist runs, collect peace orbs, and I've found with Bloodlust in my last game before I reset my save that oftentimes I'd be halfway through a level on a pacifist run, and I would be almost dead. Now, naturally, those of you out there who have even a modicum of intelligence are saying, well, doofus, don't do a pacifist run when you've got Bloodlust. But I'm not necessarily that intelligent. So, you know. Go invisible for 10 seconds. I don't actually see any enemies in our near future, so I think we're okay without being invisible. Wow, what a fall. Okay, nice little chunk of XP. We are level 22. This is one of the higher levels we've ever actually attained. I think we missed one flower, did we? Yes, we did. One rose was missed, I do believe. So we are SOL on that. Good, I did not want to trigger that alarm. I'm glad that it didn't trigger. Level 23, spawning skeletal minions, and I just a moment ago said I didn't want to trigger that alarm, and then now I just triggered it. Fall down there with my skeleton so he has something to do. Come on. Hey, more skeletons. Cool. Oh, yeah, go ahead. Go down there. Join your brother in the pit. Everybody, head down in the pit. There's a party in the pit, guys. Party in the pit. Party in the pit. Just more participants, more attendees for the party. So I am really happy with how this level's going. I'm happy with how this game is going. I think that it's one of the better runs that I've had, bar none. You know, I'm playing well. I'm staying out of trouble, staying out of too much trouble. And we don't have a particularly menacing enemy down here at the bottom. Could be that mecha goblin, and that would immediately destroy me. But luckily, we actually have a a goblin riding a troll. Yeah, weird. Okay, so let's Midas Touch. Just because, you know, Midas Touch. And can we get out of here? Yeah, five keys. Yeah, I don't... Let's throw out all our magic blades and start killing stuff. I just want to see kind of what I do to this guy in terms of damage. It's not too much. Oh, that guy's carrying an alarm on his back. That's the first time I've seen that. That is brilliant. I love it. More Midas Touch. Nothing wrong with a little Midas Touch. If he touches that, I think it will. Yes, it did. Oh, the alarm guys are great. I don't think I've ever noticed those before. They're blind and they have an alarm on their back. That is wonderful. Oh man, this is starting to get a little bit hairy. So let's maybe consider retreat. Eh, no, we got this under control. I think we can even afford to kill these guys. These additional enemies here. I mean, we're pretty okay on life, and they are probably going to drop stuff, and there's a... Oh yeah, no, now nobody wants to party in the pit, because there's a maggot in the pit, right? Is that how it works? All right, great. Hey, you showed up just in time. I literally just killed that guy. Useless. These kids are useless. These kids today. All right. This is XP, people. I know it might be boring, but it's XP, and we like XP. So part of me wants to go back up top and get that last flower. But there's an even bigger part of me that wants to just move things along. So, yeah, let's exit. I think if we blow up this brick, we'll get a couple gold pieces. Yeah, we did. Cool. So, yeah, we're going to go ahead and call it there. Call it for this level, not for the video. The video shall persist until we are done. So now we're on level 6. Probably going to try to speed things up here. I don't think that I'm powerful enough to do a whole lot. But, frankly, this methodical approach is starting to give me... a headache. Too much thinking. Okay, good. My necromancer spawn there doing a bit of work. I cannot complain about that. Not one bit. So let's start using these keys. Oh, did I really? Seriously? Oh, no. Move away. There you go. Good job. Way to clear it out. Okay, so bubbles will help us jump. I like the bubbles. There's an alarm that I actually... Hey, a squid. I didn't actually mean to hit... And we'll definitely do that shrine just because money is nice. Take that. Hello, flying squid thing. Don't kill the egg sacs because they just spawn a bunch of spiders. Okay, so yeah, it's starting to get a little harrowing now. Yeah, not good. These guys with their precision arrows. Oh, those squids fire. Okay, they fire death puppet type projectiles. Okay, so that's gonna suck. Yeah, that is absolutely gonna suck. And Stormstrider is dead. 28 plus minutes in this run. I like it. It was a good run. A really, really good run. And everything really worked out nicely there. I mean, I can't say too much negative. We were slow. I was very talky, and we moved a little bit slower than we should have. There was a military force deployed over my house, which distracted me. And other than that, I think we had a great run. Really still enjoying Vertical Drop Heroes in the utmost degree, to the utmost degree. I don't know. I think I've used up all of my intelligent conversing in the 29 minutes that we've been here live in this video. So I am going to bid you guys adieu. Do I ever say I'm going to bid you adieu? Man, my brain is fried right now. All right, guys, this has been Vertical Drop Heroes HD. I have been Big Dave. And until next time, take it easy.